we're talking about the midterms, because peer pressure. Ah, yes, the midterms, where millions, or million, of Americans come together to vote on which candidate got the most campaign contributions. Today I'm going to focus on one question: who is going to be the next Speaker of the House? As much fun as Paul Ryan was, well, he's retiring on a public pension of $85,000 a year. Poor guy, even in retirement he couldn't get away from government waste. That means that whatever happens, he's going to be replaced. So first, let's look at the Democrat Speaker of the House, because Democrats are expected to take over the House of Representatives. So I'm sure they've thought through their leader.
What's stopping you from saying now that you would support Nancy Pelosi?
Because I don't know who else is running.
I don't know who the choices are, and I certainly don't want to give any of my negotiating power away.
I don't know who would be running for that seat.
I don't know who else is going to run.
I think it's a premature question.
Ultimately, I'll make the best choice for the people of this district in terms of who I support. Any decisions about leadership will be made once all the dust is settled.
That's a conversation that I have, you know, once I'm an elected member of Congress. So
that keeps going on and on for minutes. Basically, Democrats have no idea who's going to be the Speaker of the House, which means that it's probably going to be Nancy Pelosi, because House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi just suggested she sees herself as a short-term bridge leader for Democrats, if they retake the House in 2018 and she becomes House Speaker again. And nothing shows we're the strong party who's here to take back control quite like appointing a short-term temporary leader. Now, we did have a guy in mind, but unfortunately...
It was a Bronx battle. Democrat Representative Crawley getting defeated by Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Tom. Now, she is a 28-year-old who defeated the 10-year incumbent who, quite candidly, was in line to succeed House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi.
Yep, Democrats really know how to pick them. I feel like Democrats make decisions the same way executives at DC film studios do. Hey, young new candidates are beating the people we're putting up for leadership positions. Maybe we should appoint some of them. Or, we could find someone older and more experienced. I'm thinking a Hillary Clinton type, but with a lower entry approval rating. Yeah, let's go with that. So, who are our other options? Well, Pelosi is helped by the fact that few people have openly floated challenging her. So, we're picking our leaders the same way I pick my pants. Well, that's the cleanest pair I have. I could go out and get some new ones or just kind of work with what I got. Now you know why these things are shot torso up. We do have two other candidates tacitly running, and if you're interested in getting some young reformer blood into the Democratic Party, well then keep waiting. Potentially running against her is Maryland Rep. Steny Hoyer.
I'm very positive. I think we are going to take back the House. We see all over the country a real enthusiasm and energy in our the Democratic base.
Man, I have never seen someone talk about enthusiasm and energy with that much gusto before. Thanks for rallying the troops. Yeah, let's bring in that fresh 79-year-old. It's never a good sign when Paul Ryan's starting to look hip. Steny Hoyer is most well known for taking a strong stand against a set of tax cuts 6 years ago.
Mr. Speaker, I would like to ask for unanimous consent that we bring up the bill to extend the tax cut for 160 million Americans. As you walk off the floor, Mr. Speaker, you're walking out. You're walking away.
You're walking away. You left. I'm still talking. Hello? Somebody? Powerful stuff. He's a very standard Democrat as far as what he believes in, with the exception of strongly liking Israel and supporting military intervention in the Middle East. The biggest knock against him is the accusation that he undemocratically manipulated elections for quite some time, most recently trying to force a progressive candidate to drop out of the Colorado primaries in 2018. Because a progressive winning in Colorado? That's unheard of. Regarding the odds of him actually running, Hoyer is confident Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi of California can assemble the votes necessary to become Speaker, despite calls from some Democrats to replace her. But if for some reason Pelosi doesn't become Speaker, Hoyer will run to lead House Democrats. Truly just inspirational stuff. The other person who might run is South Carolina Representative Jim Clyburn.
And waiting on the other end could be veteran South Carolina Congressman Jim Clyburn. Clyburn confirmed his intent to run if Pelosi were to fall short of the threshold, saying he would absolutely do it.
So if Democrats win, but Pelosi cannot win the minimum votes required to become Speaker of the House, he'll for sure run. He's currently the third-ranking Democrat behind Pelosi and Hoyer, who we heard from earlier, and is most known for nothing. If you've heard of this guy, odds are you've lived in South Carolina at some point in the last 27 years. Now back in 2008, there was a mini-scandal involving him and Bill Clinton when...
Is Bill Clinton out of bounds here on this?
Well, I think he really, as they would say in Gullah Geechee country, he needs to chill a little bit. And I hope he understands what that means.
Oh man, telling Bill Clinton to chill is like telling Ted Cruz to take himself a little more seriously. Dude played the saxophone! In this case, Bill Clinton was publicly attacking Jim Clyburn for endorsing Obama instead of Hillary Clinton. And not to turn this into a race thing, but telling a leading member of the Congressional Black Caucus to endorse Hillary over Obama is like trying to convince Bernie Sanders to try and take an unpaid internship at Goldman Sachs. Not gonna happen. He did endorse her in 2016 though, so if that influences you in any way, well, it happened. He's another pretty middle-of-the-road Democrat. But he's also African-American, in case any of you watching this can't see race. He's been in the House longer than I've been alive, and to repeat, will only run if Pelosi can't get enough votes to win in her party. So some of you might be wondering, isn't the Democratic Party the party of the youths? They just want Medicare reform because they've been on that plan for 20 years already. Well, younger Congress members have already made it clear that they don't want to openly challenge Pelosi, and are looking to lower-ranking leadership positions instead. Now to the Republicans, if they keep the House.
A boulder flies through the window of House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy's California office. This as someone leaves an explosive device at the New York home of billionaire investor and donor George Soros. Joining me now to discuss is the Majority Leader himself, Kevin McCarthy.
This potential and all but guaranteed speaker comes from the incredibly conservative state of California? Well, okay. Specifically Bakersfield. He's your classic Trump-era Republican, seen in that clip equating the rock someone threw through his window with the bombs mailed to Democratic leadership. And that makes sense, because as Trump recently taught us...
They want to throw rocks at our military fights back. We're going to consider it. I told him, consider it a rifle.
Who knows? Soon we might be arming teachers with rocks. That is, until the terrorists invent Bronze Age technology. This potential speaker is a pretty standard Trump-era Republican. He agrees with and defends the president on social issues. He was actually one of the few to defend the Access Hollywood tapes, and seems to have a little less shame than Paul Ryan. He wants to restrict which groups can be victims of hate crimes, thinks social media platforms censor conservatives, which is a pretty mainstream opinion on the right, and has recently been in the news because the day after George Soros' house was bombed, he posted on Twitter, "We cannot allow Soros, Steyer, and Bloomberg to buy this election. Get out and vote, Republican, November 6th, hashtag MAGA." So, bad timing there. Man, what does Bloomberg have to do with any of this? Well, I have one theory, but I really hope it's wrong. I'm not going to spend too much time on this guy, because most of the articles I'm reading talk about how he's probably going to end up being the minority leader. Which is the nice way of saying Republicans will lose the House. Less we're getting a divorce, and more, now you get two Christmases. So what does all of this mean? Well, if Democrats win, they're predicted to have the consequence be that, at the moment when the party should be celebrating huge midterm victories, unified against President Donald Trump and preparing to roll out their agenda for the future, they'll instead be fighting amongst themselves. This is because some of her colleagues are saying,
"I think it's time for change, and these election results frankly show that.
If we're going to regain the majority in 2018, we have to have new leadership."
You think right. Nancy Pelosi is more toxic than Donald Trump?
You know what? The honest answer is, in some areas of the country, yes, she is. That's the honest answer.
Congresswoman Nancy Pelosi, good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, so uncomfortable. Anyways, if she wants to be the Speaker of the House, she needs to get a majority of overall House votes. And unless she can get some Republicans, which good luck there, she's gonna have to flip some of those people we just saw. Either that, or run against one of the other two candidates mentioned above. So that's how the competition for Speaker of the House is looking right now. I certainly hope I didn't convince anyone not to vote, because remember to vote! The midterms are on Tuesday. Wow, really? Tuesday? The least remarkable day of the week. Well, okay, I didn't schedule this one. I'll be watching the speaker race as it inevitably heats up. Unless Republicans win, then it's pretty much settled. But until then, thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and remember to give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.